How's it, everyone? Welcome to another string review right here on OpenCourt. So today I'm taking a look at a Dunlop string for the first time in a while. This is one of the most popular Dunlop strings on the market. Today we're taking a look at the Dunlop Black Widow. Let's check it out. So this Black Widow string is made by Dunlop. Dunlop is a Japanese company. They make things other than tennis rackets, of course, like car tires. I actually use Dunlop tires on my car personally, and they are one of the more underrated brands in my opinion. They make good strings and rackets, the CX200 being one of my favorites. So this Black Widow comes in at an MSRP price of $12.99 a set, which makes this the cheapest polyester string in Dunlop's lineup, and it still remains a very popular string. Since this string is called the Black Widow, it only comes in black, and it comes in three gauges, 131, 126, and a 121 gauge. The Black Widow string is touted as one of the best strings for spin potential, and that comes from the heptagonal string profile. It's seven-sided, and the edges are very, very sharp. It is also supposed to be on the softer, more comfortable side of polys as well. If we take a look at the back of the package here, it's rated a 10 out of 10 for spin, and it also has a pretty high power rating at 9, which means that this is probably going to be on the softer side. So I got the Dunlop Black Widow strung up in my Dunlop CX200, and I strung it at my reference tension, 52 in the mains, 50 in the crosses. I've never actually used this Black Widow string before, so I'm excited to finally try it out and see if the hype is real, if it generates as much spin as I've heard. So let's get out on the court and test the Black Widow. Let's start with the pros of the Dunlop Black Widow. It has been a while since this string was released and many other shaped polys have come out, but this string is still one of the top rated strings for spin potential on the market. I'm happy to report that the Black Widow lives up to those ratings. This string really bites. It's also pretty pliable, so there is a lot of string displacement and snapback. The string movement coupled with the sharp edges provides so much spin. It's noticeable on just about every shot. Let's start with the serves. The kick and slice serves had so much spin, it was ridiculous. In my recent match, I hit 3 service aces. I rarely ever get one, so hitting 3 in one match was a delight. Furthermore, I had 1 ace each with my flat slice and kick serves. My kick serve ace is a prime example of the string bite. On the ad side, I was able to pull the ball down and get the serve to land in the front half of the service box right on the singles line for an out wide kick serve ace. The Black Widow's true spin potential can be unlocked by faster swingers. I don't have the fastest swings, but just about every time I swung out on ground strokes or had a clean hit on my kick serve, the string moves and snaps back with force. The faster you swing, the more the string will move and snap back, resulting in more spin. On my ground strokes, I was rewarded on my forehand if I kept a loose wrist and followed through across my waist. The natural topspin that came from my form was enhanced by the string, and I saw the ball dipping in at the last second. Heavy spin hitters and vertical swingers will benefit from the Black Widow more than flat hitters. I'll get into that a little later. Also, the slice and underspin from the Black Widow was amazing. My backhand slices cut through the air like a knife and stayed very low. I've recently incorporated slice returns into my game, and keeping the slices low and deep is the key to approaching the net after a successful slice return. The Black Widow allowed me to use this technique to its fullest, and I could approach the net after my slices easily. In terms of spin, the Black Widow lived up to its reputation without a doubt. The other thing I was pleasantly surprised with was the comfort and power. As I said earlier, the Black Widow is a pliable string and therefore had a comfortable response. It's not as soft as some of the comfort-oriented polys out there, but it felt softer than Dunlop Explosive Spin. If you only have mild arm pain, I don't think the Black Widow will make it worse, but you should be careful just the same. This softer response led to a respectable amount of power and pop. The ball really sinks into the string bed on full strokes and slingshots out of the racket. The sharp edges, soft feel, and thin gauge results in great ball pocketing. If you like slightly more powerful polys like I do, this string will provide decent help with power. I think the power level is similar to Headlink's Tour, but Black Widow feels slightly softer. The power was most evident on two particular strokes. The flat serve was the first. I could hit some flat bombs with the Black Widow that I usually can't with my low-powered CX200. The springiness led to easy net clearance as well. The second shot was my backhand. Because I have a two-hander, I can't hit with a whole lot of pace. However, the Black Widow helped me hit some heavy, penetrating backhands. My hitting partner commented that my backhands were particularly solid and steady. This gave me a boost in confidence and I really enjoyed my backhand with this string. There was ample put-away power on volleys and overheads as well. I didn't really have to work that hard at the net, which was nice, and also the string put some natural underspin on my volleys. And lastly, for a softer poly, the Black Widow actually held tension pretty well. At the beginning, the string wasn't stiff, but the sharp edges caused the strings to get stuck out of place. But once it settled in and the string started snapping back, the control improved and didn't really drop off for the first couple sessions. After that, the string lost tension at a natural pace, but for a softer poly, it's on the longer lasting side, so I was impressed. So overall, I was pleasantly surprised with the Black Widow, but that's not to say the string is perfect. Let's talk about what disappointed me. So with the cons of the Black Widow, although there were a few, I don't want to take away from the pros because I really did enjoy this string, but the feel is what kind of let me down. The Black Widow is a pretty muted and dampened string. I prefer crisper and livelier strings so I can hit my placement and touch shots. It was easier for me to hit angles from the baseline because the spin let me aim for the sidelines with confidence, but I couldn't really gauge the touch on drop shots and angle volleys. But this wasn't as big an issue as it is with most other dead strings like RPM Blast or Vocal Cyclone, because the Black Widow actually has decent dwell time, so I can still feel the ball sinking in on full aggressive strokes. The slower touch shots are the only area where I struggled. For these particular shots, a more lively feel is definitely going to benefit me when it comes to hitting drop shots where I can gauge my strength and be able to drop it exactly where I'm aiming. Next con is that the Black Widow is most likely lacking in the durability department. I'll admit this is just a guess because I didn't break the strings during this playtest, but I always cut strings out before they break anyway. Just the soft construction and the sharp edges leads me to believe the Black Widow will snap if you put it in a more open pattern or if you hit with aggressive spin. Durability is not a top priority for me, but if you're looking for a longer lasting string, I don't think the Black Widow is that. And lastly, and this was a minor issue, but I did notice a slight lack of control when I tried to flatten out my shot. Just for clarification, my flat serve was great. I'm talking about my flat forehand, particularly my return. I like to step in and take an aggressive half swing with my forehand return. More often than not, I tend to hit that shot pretty flat, and with this Black Widow, I sailed quite a bit of returns. This leads me to believe that the Black Widow is most likely not suited for flatter hitters because of the springy response and above average power level. More vertical swingers that impart plenty of spin through their form and follow through will benefit more from this string than someone who swings more horizontally. So lastly, let's discuss who the Dunlop Black Widow is for. Well, I just said it in my previous segment. It's not for flat hitters, but those who have the mechanics to impart plenty of spin will enjoy the Black Widow because this string really bites, as the name suggests. Also, if you're looking for a slightly softer poly that provides decent power, this string can check both boxes. This string really shines on the serves, both flat and spin. So if your main weapon is your serve, this string can make holding serve easier. Although the durability is probably not the greatest, the tension maintenance is respectable for a soft poly, so this would be a string I would probably play with until it breaks. Seeing as how it is under $10, I wouldn't complain much if it broke after 2 weeks, honestly. So far, I haven't tried too many of Dunlop's strings, but I was very impressed with the Black Widow, and for me, the hype and reputation of this string is well deserved, particularly the bite and snapback. I'm thinking of trying this string again in hybrid setups in the future to get a little more feel with a round and crisp poly cross. If you haven't tried this string, I highly recommend the Dunlop Black Widow for all your spin needs. Thank you for watching this review of the Dunlop Black Widow string right here on OpenCourt. If you guys like this content, be sure to overhead smash that like and subscribe button, and I'll see you on an OpenCourt.